Now that we discussed Facebook and Twitter, it's time to talk about Instagram. Instagram is a mobile application that combines the features of a photo sharing site and a social networking site. It was recently acquired by Facebook and its popularity is skyrocketing. It now has more subscribers than Twitter, over 300 million monthly users. Unlike other social networks where people can also post images and videos, on Instagram, no standalone text updates are allowed. People have to share an image or a short video of up to 15 seconds. Anytime you upload a media file, you can apply special filters to it, crop images, change color, adjust the contrast, luminosity, saturation, and other options. This makes Instagram a highly visual social network. Moreover, even if Instagram can be browsed from the web like any other social media site, photos and videos can only be uploaded from mobile devices. The types of interactions allowed are very similar to Twitter. You can mention someone, follow them, send them a DM, and add hashtags to your posts. But just like Facebook, you can also like other people's posts and comment on them. If you see a photo that you really like and that is posted by someone else, you can repost it using another app called Repost app. There are two versions of it, a free one and a paid one, but the free one is perfectly okay. It just leaves the name of the user who originally posted the image on a corner of the image. Really, you don't need to pay for the premium version. On your profile, you have a profile photo, a space for your bio, and an external link. So that's all you need to fill before you're ready to go. In our next lecture, we are going to look at how you can use Instagram to find new potential customers. But before you switch to the next video, I have homework for you. Visit the Instagram account of one of your competitors or future competitors if you haven't launched your product yet, and take a look at what kind of content they share, how often they post, and how successful they are in terms of interactions they generate. Then move on to our next lecture and see whether what we discussed resonates with your findings. See you there.